Friends, we studied random experiment, how to write the sample space for that random experiment. Now, what is the meaning of event? How to write the number of points in the event? Okay, now we will go for the next topic, that is probability. So, students, in mathematical language, the possibility of any event is expressed in the form of number, and that is called as probability. Probability also can be expressed in the form of fraction, or it is also expressed in the form of percentage. Okay, suppose for example, for any random experiment, S is the sample space. For any random experiment, S is the sample space. N of S is the sample points in sample space. For this experiment, let A be the event and N of A be the number of sample points in event A. Then how to write the probability of event A? So probability of event A is written as P of A, like this way, and we will read it as probability of event A. It is having formula number of sample points in event A divided by number of sample points in sample space. In sample space. Okay. So, therefore, we will get the formula probability of event A, P of A, is equal to number of sample points in event A, means N of A, upon number of sample points in sample space, means N of S. So this is the formula to find out the probability of an event. Okay. Now students, always remember that the probability of any event is greater than equal to 0 or less than equal to 1. Okay. Suppose for this probability of event A. This probability of event A may be greater than equal to 0 or it is less than equal to 1. It is never less than 0 or it is never greater than 1. Understood? So, this point we have to remember. So, let us see one example for random experiment. A die is thrown. Find the probability of getting a number greater than 2. Followed? A die is thrown. This is the random experiment. We have to find the probability of getting a number greater than 2. Okay. So first we will write the sample space. A die is thrown. Therefore, sample space is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. And therefore, number of sample point is 6. Okay. This we already know. Now, the event is number getting greater than 2. So let here we will give the name for this event as A. Let A be the event of getting number greater than 2. Therefore, A is equal to, now which numbers are greater than 2? 3, 4, 5, 6. And therefore, N of A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, here they mention find the probability. So, we will use this formula. The event is E, therefore probability of event A is equal to N of A upon N of S. N of A is 4, N of S is 6, and now we can simplify this. 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6. So the probability of getting a number greater than 2 is 2 upon 3. Followed? Understood how to find out the probability of any event? Let us solve some examples from practice set 5.4. Question number 1. If two coins are tossed, find the probability of the following events. There are two events. First one is getting at least one head and second one is getting no head. Okay. So let us We will solve the example here. We will write the experiment first. Two coins are tossed. Let S be the sample space. Let S be the sample space, therefore S is equal to two coins are tossed. So the first possibility is both the coins will get head HH, first coin head or second coin tail, first coin tail, second coin head, and both the coins will have tail TT. Therefore N of S is equal to 4. Followed. Now we will write event. First one. Now we require the name for the event to find the probability. So let we will give the name for the event. The first event be A. So let A be the event of getting at least one head. Let A be the event of getting at least one head. Therefore, A is equal to curly bracket. Now, we require at least one. Again here, at least one means minimum one head. That means one or more than one head. So which results we will take? HH, HT and TH. HH, HT and TH. Last one we will not take because we require minimum one head. Okay. Therefore, N of A is equal to 3. Followed. Now here they mention find the probability. Student, when read the question properly, if probability is asked, you have to find out probability. Otherwise, you will lose marks for that state. Okay. So probability of event A, as according to our formula, P of A is equal to N of A upon N of S. Okay. Equal to n of a is 3 and n of s is 4. Therefore, here p of a is equal to 3 upon 4. Followed very simple how to find out the probability. Next set is second event. Second event they gave getting no head. So we will give the name for this event. Let B be the event of getting no head. Therefore, B is equal to TT. We don't want head, so both the results will be 10. And therefore, N of B is equal to 1. And then probability. Therefore, probability of event B is P of B. Equal to, now instead of N of A, we will write here N of B upon N of S. N of B is 1 and N of S is 4. Therefore, probability of event B is 1 upon 4. Followed. And then we will write the answer. Okay. First answer is probability of getting at least one head is 3 upon 4. And second answer, probability of getting no head is 1 upon 4. Followed, then your solution is completed. Follow question number 3. There are 15 tickets in a box, each bearing one of the numbers from 1 to 15. One ticket is drawn at random. Find the probability of event that the ticket drawn shows an even number and ticket drawn shows a number which is a multiple of 5. Okay. Now, student, first you understood the experiment. There is one box and in that box there are 15 tickets. And on each ticket there is one number from 1 to 15. And any one ticket is drawn randomly. So, what are the possibilities in this experiment? Yes, we may get the number from 1 to 15. Any number we will get. So, we have to consider all the numbers. So, therefore, we will write the sample space as 1, 2, 3 up to 15. Therefore, N of S is equal to 15. Now, first event is that the ticket drawn is even number. So, we will give the name for event A. The ticket drawn shows an even number. So, from 1 to 15, which are the even numbers? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 and 14. Because the last number is 15. So, here we will get 14 even number. So, N of A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. According to the formula, probability of event A is equal to N of A upon N of S. So, 7 upon 15. So, probability of event A is 7 upon 15. Next event is the ticket drawn shows a number which is multiple of 5. We will give the name for this event B. The ticket drawn shows a number which is multiple of 5. So which numbers are multiple of 5 from 1 to 15? First number is 5. Second number is 10. And third number is 15. So n of b is equal to 1, 2, 3. Therefore p of b is equal to n of b upon n of s. 3 upon 15. So it is simplified. 3 1 the 3, 3 5 the 15. 1 upon 5. So probability of event b is 1 upon 5. Now we will write the answer in statement. First answer is probability of ticket drawn shows an even number is 7 upon 15. And second answer, probability of ticket drawn shows a number multiple of 5 is 1 upon 5. Question number 5. A card is drawn at random from a pack of well-shuffled 52 playing cards. Find the probability that the card drawn is, first one is an ace card and second one is a spade card. Okay. Now student, here they mention there are 52 playing cards. Okay, as I already explained you, in that playing cards there are 4 types of cards. Okay, diamond, heart, spade and club. And each type of 13 cards are there. 13 for the 52. Diamond and heart are having red color and spade and club are having black color. Okay. Now, here these playing cards are well shuffled. Shuffled. That means we don't know which card you will get. So, there is a possibility of all 52 cards. Any one card you will get. Okay. So, when such type of question comes, so we don't have to write the sample space. We will directly write N of S. Okay. Let S be the sample space. Therefore, N of S is equal to 52. And because there are various different types of cards are there in these playing cards. The king is there, queen is there, jack is there. S is there. So, we can't write it in sample space. Okay. So, we will directly write N of S is equal to 52. Now, we will take first event. Event A. The card drawn is an S card. The card drawn is an S. So, in each type of card, there is only one S. Okay? So, there are 4 types of cards. So, there are how many S cards? 4 S cards. So, here we will write, there are 4 S cards. Therefore, N of A is equal to 4. Therefore, N of A is equal to 4. Now, we will write the probability of event A. Now, I hope you understood the formula. N of A upon N of S. N of A is 4 and N of S is 52. So, we can simplify this. 4 ones are 4. Here, 4 1 the 4 and 4 3 the 12. So the probability of event A is 1 upon 13. P of A is equal to 1 upon 13. Let's second event we will take. This is first event. Second event B. The card drawn is a spade. So just now I explain you there are 13 heart cards, 13 diamond cards, 13 spade cards and 13 club cards. And here we want only spade cards. So how many spade cards are there? 13. So like this we will write the statement. There are 13 spade cards. Therefore, N of B is equal to 30. We will find out probability. Probability of event B is equal to N of B upon N of S. N of B is 13. N of S is 52. 13 ones are 13 fours are. Therefore, P of B is equal to 1 upon 4. Followed? So when the question comes related to 52 playing cards, we can write down this way. Understood? Now we will write the answer. First answer. Probability of the card drawn is an S is 1 upon 13, and second answer, probability of the card drawn is a spade card is 1 upon 4.